that's my first answer to that. And it's difficult to believe that. It's human like every other person. It's my grown up with him. I saw him as a man, a superman. Not just a superman in that aspect, a very spiritual man. He's the greatest prophet I've ever met as a human being on this planet. So when he died, it was, in short, when he exited to you, a surprise to me. And nobody thought of death for such a man. He was very strong, very agile. And even before he exits to play, he would tell me to leave what I'm carrying. Maybe I'm carrying something heavy that can fall. Is that it? This same man at 84 would tell me to drop it. That is too heavy for me. And he's going to carry it at that age. So if they tell you that such a person is gone, how will you feel? With such energy and such strength. So it's surprising to me because I saw him as someone that is larger than life, someone that is larger than death. Because when I was discussing with my siblings, I was like, keep that money from me, that can never die. Because there are some people who feel that this person can live it. They are all Christians, they are all women, we know that they are accountable to God and one day will be the whole time. So I believe it's the last time because he gave so many prophecies regarding his death. I don't know whether I should go on.
Yes, go ahead.
In the church service, where he had so many big pictures, the rivals.
Before his birthday.
Yes, before his birthday. Yes, before his birthday, before his 85th birthday. In one of the annual Christmas carol service, where you have a lot of guests and the entire church member there. And I said, well, he didn't want to scare the wife that two generals came and he saw them, they had so many stars. And they said, we came to take him. He was about 3 days with this general to give him small time to allow him to do something that he was ready to do. And he said that in the open church, nobody knew what was going to happen. But to our surprise, immediately after that revelation, Baba started the expansion of one of the branches in Akite. He also went to Ifeanyi State to build a very big church, a big auditorium. And when they did the commissioning of that auditorium, the turnout of congregation and crowd was over 1,000 times. So it was after that, and also he wants to open that cathedral, that congregation in the church at Ife on his 85th birthday. But because of the tiles and that other thing, those that know Baba knows that he has taste, he has class as a former architect. So even days before his birthday, luckily you were also around. He called me personally and said, Larry, I don't want to. He said, I don't want to celebrate this birthday. He said it and I was shocked at that. But why don't you want to celebrate your birthday? I said, allow. He said, Larry, you could hear. Truly could hear me. Meaning that you can't understand. I said, oh, my wife, you're still alive. Why won't you celebrate your birthday? He said, no. I said, no, since you're alive, so in his typical set, he just kept quiet and he allowed the children to do what he wanted to do. And preceding that, I also have a personal experience with him, which our publisher, Mr. Sherekeng, will also testify. The last Christmas carol in the church, I was not there and he was not very comfortable. Fine, I went to study abroad and he got to a point, he just started insisting that I had to come in for his birthday. So he knew. And because he saw me that I was reluctant in coming in, he actually stopped talking to my wife on the phone. Feeling maybe because I didn't want to come because of my family. And the day I called him and I said, Baba, I bought my ticket and coming for your birthday. He said, Lyle, give the phone to your wife. And Baba prayed for my wife for 30 minutes. I didn't know there was more to it. So after that call, after we joined, I told my wife that is there more to me coming home that Baba is taking so serious? I never knew things were happening. While I was still there in the US, he also told me, he said, Baba, when you come, they are not coming straight to your house. That was, you know, he was speaking in private, you know, you've been away for 2 years. I don't want you to come straight to your house so that you're not being, I want you to stay with me for 1 month. And he did a place to world class standard for me in his house. And the only thing he put in that room was the Bible that he uses, his personal Bible. He put that out. He said, I would like to take it to that room. He put AC, painted, he did renovation, so many things, and he just put the Bible in the middle of the room. 1 month, he got to say, I want him to stay there. He died exactly after 1 month. So I think he had prepared his exit. He said 1 month, he died exactly. So that's why most of all, especially me, I'm still in shock. Exactly after that 1 month, I said that she's going to the team. Was when he went. Exactly how he went. So he's a man that knew about his death, but as human, it is natural for us to mourn, it's natural for us to grieve, and it's natural for us to miss. The man that is so caring. Our father is caring not just as a father, but he has also a motherly love, which is the love that Christ gave to the world. So he had that attribute of Christ in him. People that dealt with him all testified to that. And I think the satisfaction I have now is that even friends that came that had no access to the church, they stayed outside, there was a marquee outside. It was overflowed with crowd, that the number of people in that marquee sitting were not half the number of people standing inside the marquee. The number of people on the road were more than the people in the marquee and also in the church. And one of my friends said, Lion, you don't have to cry about your father. That's what everybody, if what everybody is saying is true about your father, they don't cry that the man has gone to meet the saint that is in heaven. That everybody kept saying one good thing after the other. That different people where he was. That, so he said, so why are you mourning? So that this man has gone to rest. That is just, I believe, is the last time, because on Sunday, which was on his birthday, he called our firstborn, which is our eldest child, Mrs. Otusoya, that's the wife of Professor Otusoya, and told her, he said, you and they told you church could they told you mine. How can somebody on his 85th birthday that was not hospitalized, that was not sick, be telling the firstborn to take care of the church and also take care of the last one? And when my dad said that to my sister, she immediately called every one of us that this is what Baba said, and that is Baba telling me this. And that our response to Baba was that, and you know they might talk to church for me, and you know they might talk to Lali. So Baba said that on Sunday and died on Thursday. So his death is a mystery to us, but it was known to God and also known to Baba through revelation and things Baba was saying before he died. And some things happened, like the friend I said before we started this interview. Baba exited to glory on Thursday, so the condolence register was immediately opened on that Thursday. Most people started coming from different parts of the state and even from the world. People traveled from US and London to pay condolence to the family. So a particular frame was used, which to us was a beautiful frame, very nice frame. But when I slept, that was that Thursday night to Friday night. You know, Baba in Revelation in trance, you know that he wants something final, that he had prepared it for himself. And truly and behold, the place he took me to in that dream, in that trance, he kept the frame, he covered it with a bigger picture, and nobody knew that was a frame there. So when I woke up that next morning, I went through that same route, I went to the city room, I saw the frame at the back of the big picture. I was like, okay, there was no picture, nothing inside, it was just empty. So I took the frame, called the printer that Baba always used to do photo and printing for me. On my way up, I saw my mom and she was like, ah, Lion, do the TV frame. I'm using my exact word. That's Lion, where did you see this frame? And I said, I explained everything that happened to her. So everyone that said he wants a better frame. And if you look at the frame, truly, it was a beautiful frame for Baba to have kept without everybody knowing. And immediately we took the frame, we changed it, and we used that for his condolence. So many other things have happened. One happened even on his on the day of his burial, which was the 17th of September. we were going around, you know, and when we got to the street of the church, the driver was there, his name is Gani. These are witnesses, because when things are happening, when you have witnesses, it shows they are stating the facts. The wife was there, Mother Akibu alone. And also a friend, a family friend was also there. Honorable Kayo Akibu is a member of House of Representatives. He was inside Baba's car, inside his chihuahua. And I told him, I said, this is what Baba said, that it's going to rain. I said it, told I do. I said, it's going to rain, but it's not going to rain until they take the casket, that is his corpse, inside the church where it's covered, that it's going to rain. But until they take his all and behold, immediately they took that casket inside the church, it rained heavily. And everybody in the car was like, wow. Carol even in his said, I think, wow, La Wakuba. He said something, you know, to show that, wow, this God is great.
And I was as a witness too.
So you witnessed that immediately they took his casket inside, it rained. That water that the rain immediately. So he is everywhere. He has figured he has appeared to so many people. To my brother, to people that are close to him. So he's no, that's amazing. I wish my mom is there. That was scary. My, you can see my sister, that one is really scary. We brought him home on Thursday for the lying estate and baking. So we went there in the morning because Baba was speaking to us in different ways to do one or two things. Baba was everywhere. So myself and my sister went to where Baba's body was. And we prayed. What he said we should do, we did it. So we had to lift the cover. The first one was the transparent so that people could see. So we went there, we lifted it. I think my sister was at the back. So she didn't put the cover properly on the case. So she put it on Baba's leg. It was resting on his leg. So when my mom went there, I went with her to pray. And we're still there, right where Baba's head is, not his leg. And I told my mom that, Baba said they are putting this thing on his leg. I don't know what I understand. I said, Mommy, Baba said they are putting the cover on his leg. My mom now said that, well, basically, let's say that was him, putting it on his leg. Ah. We now went to where his leg was. That thing was on his leg. My mom now said that, you see, Baba, it's equal. We now looked, we were like, we now carried it, we now put it properly at the back of his leg. So it's, So for me, I tell people, I don't like people discussing because to me, I feel it's not, I don't know, that's my feeling because Christ didn't die. He ascended into glory. And if you look at where Baba said, we should bury him. These are things, I think, Chronicle of history, and I'm happy that city people is actually doing this. When you go to the Chronicle, when you go to the history of what Baba has done, he prepared a site for himself. At that site, he did artwork already there. And what they wrote there, Jesus Christ ascended to heaven. I will take you there, you see, he did it there himself. And he put a frame already that when he dies on that, you should bury him there and put his picture at that particular frame that he already prepared for himself. So this is a man that already prepared for his death. He knew then he was going to, and already made preparation for it. So he did so many things that I cannot even say on the media, you know. You know when Elijah died, he didn't die with his power. He gave that man to double portion to Elisha. These things, I read it in the Bible. I watch it on TV. You know when you watch things, you see electric something. So Baba didn't die. I can say it. But he didn't die with it. He didn't die with it. He left it. But he did what he was supposed to do. He died. He did what he was supposed to do. He died.
So if you look at, if you take all his activity while he was still very much active, would you say that, how would you define all the things he tried to do, people to those who met him or those who came in contact with him and all that? What were the things that he left behind for them?
The first thing I would say is that Baba's relationship with anybody that comes across him is a relationship of sincerity, love, and integrity.
Baba will accommodate anybody, irrespective of your social status, irrespective of your religion. Because when Christ came, Christ did not come for religion. So Baba did not come for religion. Baba came for salvation. That is what I learned about him. And his relationship with people, Baba will start with humility.
Yeah.
And the first thing that will strike you about him is that if you don't know him, you don't know what he has or what he has achieved, and you meet him outside, like, who is this man? But when you now meet him, Vinny, Joseph, you mean this is who this man is, and he's so humble to that level. So he will relate with you with humility, and Baba will listen to whatsoever problem you have. And apart from listening to whatever problem you have, Baba has a very powerful prophetic power. I'm saying this as a son, and everybody that I come in contact with him, he tell me this, that even as a lawyer, when I have kids, I'll take my client to my ear. No, that's for you to know the level of confidence and what I know he can do. Even as a lawyer, let's go and meet Baba. But before you pray, before you finish prayer, and Baba will give you vision, revelation about your life, even things you have done in the secret, you'll be wondering, okay, how did this man know? It's not him, it's God. So God gave him that prophetic power to see hidden secrets. And when you have an understanding of hidden secrets, that is when you can solve people's problems. It's not just about making noise. And Baba has a spiritual understanding, and which was what he gave to us as his children, that there are different situations in life, and there are different solutions to different problems. Two of you can have the same problem of, let's say, financial problem. But yours can just be prayer, and you have a breakthrough. But another person may need something else. That's why the Jesus Christ will open the eyes of the blind. Your father keeps telling us this. And you see another blind, Jesus Christ will mix his saliva with clay, put it on the eyes to heal that person. Are you saying Jesus Christ cannot say, open your eyes and be opened? No, but there are different things to different people's problems. So God gave you that in-depth understanding of spiritual healing. You know, when the water in Mara was bitter, they could not drink that water. What the prophet did was to get salt. He said, bring salt, let's add it. And the problem of that whole country was solved. Not just going there to pray, a solution, something must be done for that water to have its solution or its healing. So God gave him some in-depth understanding as to what and what to do with prayer. You know, at times, that's why Jesus Christ said, these things cannot be done except through fasting and prayer. So it's fasting, prayer, and understanding of spirituality. So when people come in contact with Baba, Baba will pray, and after praying, Baba will fast along the way. And not just fast and pray, but Baba will seek divine intervention from God to ensure that that problem is solved. Because when people are coming to you as a man of God, when people are coming, they see Christ in you, and everybody that came to Christ got healing. Even the woman with the issue of blood only had faith that only when I touch the garment. So people have gotten to that level with Baba, they believe that, no, truly, God is with this man. So that is why you see former president, sitting president, former governor, because they know he's not somebody that will lie because he wants to get money. He's not even interested in anybody's, because God has already blessed him. And I'm happy you had the testimony of the members of the church, everybody that other churches, pastors collect money from them. But in his own church, it's different, that he gives money out to his members. So his own healing, his own miracle was not, you will not see him in the news, on the media, like every other man of God showing miracle. He was not into publicity, but he was doing it to the glory of God. And people really appreciated that. That's why you see people talk about it, that they met, somebody said it. These are clips, chronicles I wish you could put together. The governor said it, that he has met, you know what that means. Once you're a governor, you have met so many pastors, you have met so many affairs, you have met so many magicians, you have met so many abbalists in your life. Though you may not go to all those routes, but at least you have met so many pastors, so many affairs, you know. He said he has seen so many men of God, so many spiritual people, that he has never met anybody like that. And why he said that, he said, because that is very honest And Baba has integrity. And Baba will never lie. So, and that is what Christ has said, that you must always stand with the truth. And that is what will set you free. So you cannot be a Christian and be lying. You cannot be a Christian and people will not see healing in what you are doing as a man of God. So Baba lived a very exemplary life that is worthy of emulation, and is a legacy he have left. You know when they say they have left a shoe that nobody can feel? I don't know who can feel this shoe. It's a very big shoe for anybody to feel. But with the grace and the power of Almighty God, he left so many able children. So many, there are pastors, two pastors, a prophet, a venerable. So he gave us Christ, not just himself or his member. The first thing that God gave all the children is Christ. And none of us has departed, and none of us will depart by the power of God from that Christ that Baba has given us. And the little I know about Baba, Baba did not mix anything with his God. That I can say as his son, he never mixed anything with his God. Even when Baba prays for you, he needs solution. It's nothing but maybe fruit. I'm telling you, maybe fruit, maybe salt or water. Just nothing that nothing like blood, just fruits, herbs, leaves. Maybe you are finding it difficult to sleep. Baba will just say, maybe just take one or two leaves and take that's all. Not he will get that revelation of what that person should take. So it's not that they're going to kill ram, they're going to kill cow. No, it doesn't do all that. Just prayer, water, and anointing, that's all. And the person will receive healing. Because I can remember the man also gave that testimony in church, Justice Adewale, the judge. She was giving a judgment, and suddenly, you know, in those days where people are very fetish, so they seized the voice of the judge. The judge could not pronounce the judgment. They call it Agada and Godo. Yes, they call it Agada and Godo. That's all right. They seized that person's voice. The judge could not talk again because of just to pronounce the judgment in court. So they came to Baba, and Baba said, this is what they are doing. And Baba prayed. And where they did the thing, the padlock got broken. And the person could talk. And he went back to the person that did it. So these are just, there are several things, miracles that God has used. It's not him. Because when Baba does something, Baba will tell him, give the glory to God, that I can't do it by myself. That the revelation, the inspiration, and everything is God. He will let the person in. So your appreciation is to go to God, and you will tell that person to move closer to God and forsake sin. That if God can do this for you, then you should know this is the God you should serve. And Baba will not say because he has healed you, he has done this, you should come to his church. Baba will only tell you to go to Christ. That's why you will not say because no, you say go to Christ, worship God. Wherever you just make sure you worship God. So everybody that came in contact with him had a wonderful experience, a memorable experience that you'll be surprised that at times when I see outsiders cry, I'm like, okay, why are you crying more than, you know why I say you cry more than you believe? I'm not kidding. You know, I see so many people, directors, PS, governors, maybe, I don't even want to mention them, the former president, he was crying like a baby. So at the point I'm like, okay, why are these people crying more than, you know, at the point I'm like, is it that I have more money? My dad, the way I should, but because of the relationship, and I think what they have benefited spiritually from him, they're like, oh, so this man is no more. And his death to us all is also a lesson that no matter how powerful you are, no matter how strong you are, we are all accountable to one thing, that means death. So, and the last message that God gave us is that, Amapa the lion, that was his last word to the world, to the children, to everybody. Amapa the lion, meaning that we meet in joy. Yeah. And the only way we can meet Baba in joy is to live a life that is holy. We should live a righteous life. Like Christ said in the book of Matthew, that seek first the kingdom of God and its righteousness. So we must seek the kingdom of God in righteousness, doing what is right, forsaking sin. That is when we can meet Baba in joy.
How do you say it?
The 3 days funeral of Baba is
is amazing, it's historic, because the burial was done in 2 weeks. And the first question everybody were asking is that, why 2 weeks? And being who Baba is, he gave so many instructions before he died. He does not want his body to be taken to the highest. You know, he gave so many reasons, he's not just another person. And you cannot go against such a structure, even if you get the consequence yourself. So we had to do everything within 2 weeks, but we didn't do it. God was with us, His Spirit was with us, and the turnout was, I won't say it was not expected, it was expected. I won't say it was not expected, but it was not as expected as what came up. The crowd was too much, the whole street, the whole area was standstill. The whole environment, the whole of Bagada was standstill, and from the first day to the second day to the third day, everything went smoothly. All glory to God, there was no problem, there was no issue, and we could even feel His presence, you know, everywhere. We could feel, when He has reached, we could feel Baba. And so many people said something, and they said, this brother can only be God. Yeah, because the testimony people are giving, and the way the event was organized, you know, it was organized as if we planned it for 4 months or 6 months. But it wasn't planned, it was just God's handwriting, because this is His general that is there. His general must be giving a befitting there. So God took charge. And the crowd was amazing. It's just a testimony that a great man is dead. So they all came to pay their last respect for him. One man came, and I think I should share this testimony with you. I will mention him because it's a testimony. His name is Tonjo. He has a very big electrical store. Tonjo. He has a big electrical store in Nevada. The man came, said he saw it in the Nation newspaper. He traveled there, said he was in Abuja, that he had to come, that where he was in Abuja, that he was still thinking about coming to meet Baba. And he shared the testimony with my mom that he wanted to marry a lady. And the family said he cannot marry that lady because he's a poor man. And that he really loved that woman. That he was crying for months, for weeks. He now came to meet Baba and he was crying. So Baba, this is what happened to me when I said, don't cry. That God is going to turn the situation around. That you will not be referred to as a poor man, but a rich man. Say that Baba took him up, his case up, because he was really down, that so they could deny him love and marriage because he was not rich. So say Baba prayed for him, we prayed together. And Baba said he's going to have one or two dreams about something, and truly, he had those dreams. And his fortune changed, that what he now did when he had money was that he went to the street of those he's supposed to be in-laws, that he went to buy the tallest building in that street. That he went to that street, that he went to buy the tallest building in that street. That was his first property but he went to their street to buy the biggest building there. He gave them a ridiculous amount that the owner would sell it. That from there he bought almost all the houses on that street. And the family started regretting that, only if we had known, we'd have allowed our daughter to marry this person. That's somebody's testimony that I didn't know, even my mom didn't know. The man came and was like, he was crying like a baby. That where he was in Abuja, that was still thinking of coming to me, but that Baba should pray for him again. You know, that, you know, he has touched so many lives. And even somebody gave a testimony, we didn't know that Baba sponsored that person to school. He said, we didn't know, right there. We nobody knew, not even the wife. He said, Baba, I don't know when they're in school. Really, Baba sent him to school. And we didn't know. We didn't know. So he has touched so many lives. And I think we all are going to miss him. But the only comfort we have, just like Jesus Christ said, that is God, but he's going to send a comforter to us, which is the Holy Spirit. So we also believe that Baba is not God. He has exceeded to glory and is very much our bond spiritually with us.